Hey guys, Genome here with another StarCraft II commentary. We're going to have Arath as the Red Terran at the 12 o'clock, up against Reno as the Blue Zerg at the 6, and this map is Metalopolis. Somewhat unfortunately, I do know what one of these players is going to go for. I do not know the outcome of the match, though. Let's see, Arath is a Redditor, like me. And he uploaded this replay a little bit, I think maybe 2 weeks ago or a week and a half ago or something. I'm actually not sure what rank he is right now or when or what he was when he uploaded this. Looks like he's just going to wall off first. And Reno going to send his overlord in the wrong direction. Metalopolis is a four-player map, so it looks like Reno is going to send the closest one by air. Or send the overlord to the closest one by air. Slightly early pool from Reno, getting it at 10. That's, well, not really slightly early, as much as just a different build than we've seen in the last few games. This probably will be my last commentary for today because my voice is starting to get tired again. Looks like Reno is going to send out a drone scout. Also to the wrong position, not going to see anything here. So by then, Arath should have his wall up. Getting standard gas time. Actually, that's a little bit early. So, yeah, just gonna, yeah, even putting three SCVs on it pretty quick. Arath gonna get out that first Marine. Actually, not gonna put down a supply depot to block off his, or to finish off his wall. Six links coming up from Reno, we'll see. I kind of doubt that they'll be able to do too much. But Arath really should put up that supply depot to make sure nothing comes in. He is getting that orbital command up right now. Looks like even four more links coming out from Reno. That's quite an odd choice. I'm not sure if he knows that he's going up against a Terran, but if he does, then he really shouldn't be building more Zerglings. Yeah, that wall gonna stop it. This single Marine gonna be able to do a lot of damage. We'll see if it's enough to prevent this wall from going down. Upon seeing these Lings, Arath really should be pumping another one. So, there we go, that wall gonna complete. This Marine going to be able to do pretty good damage. Yeah, this wall takes a little bit of damage, but it's not going to go down anytime soon. Arath getting more barracks. Oh, and a factory. But, okay, there we go. Going to train another Marine, another two Marines. Even going to leave an SCV here, just going to make sure that this wall is healthy or not. Actually going to put down an early Ghost Academy. Excuse me. This is pretty early, considering he's facing off against Zerg. Against Protoss, it's not completely strange to get an Academy this early, because EMP is just so useful against almost every Protoss unit. There's the only units that aren't really affected by it are, like, Probes and Zealots, and, well, even Zealots lose a third of their health in their combat units. So, Probes and Warp Prisms, which die to anything. Alright, Arath even gonna get a first Hellion out to prevent those Zerglings from doing any real damage. Strangely enough, Reno not expanding. Not yet, anyway. Yes, I walked, and that Ghost actually coming up pretty quickly. We'll see if he goes for an early nuke. Okay, yeah, he's gonna go for an early nuke. That's the part that was spoiled for me, so now you know. Alright, another Hellion coming out from Arath. We'll see what exactly he does with this Ghost. Because usually, in general, cloaking is really... Yeah, but gonna go for that nuke? That's right off. Looks like he might just plant down a nuke here. Reno gonna expand to this main. That's really unusual. Much more difficult to defend, but he takes the risk of Arath not scouting it. looks like Arath now going to move out. Those Hellions getting really separated from these infantry units. And yeah, it looks like even rallying to, what unit are they rallying to? One of the Hellions. So that nuke should be mostly done, yeah, just about finishing. And now Cloak is being researched, but that's going to take another 2 minutes. These Hellions are going to be able to do pretty good damage, micro at all. Actually, just going to send out a nuke there. Should be able to do a lot of damage to this Lair Union. Yeah, to the spawning pool as well. And now, blocking the ramp, he's going to be able to keep the ghost alive. I think... Wow, that nuke is going to land. Yeah, take out almost every drone. The only way Reno could have stopped this is by using his queen. And getting a little lucky. Arath going to lose those Hellions, but not going to matter at this point. Reno just so far behind in the economy. He does have this base up, but he doesn't have... the money to, well, he does have a decent amount of money, but it doesn't really matter. I think Arath could be better off sitting back here, snapping out anything that, yeah, here we go. Just gonna sit back here, and then any drones that try and come by will die. That spawn pool will go down, no problem. And Reno should have GG'd once the nuke landed, maybe even when the nuke was being painted. So yeah, Arath gonna win this pretty convincing win. This goes with 25 kills with Commander. The Queen popping out just to die. Not gonna be kills, nope. Sniper even. And this Lair gonna go down pretty quickly. Let's look at the income tab. Okay, here we have Reno getting this nice 120 gas. And 100 minerals per minute versus Arath's 960, and Reno's still not GG'ing. So by now Arath has to know that something's up, so I assume they'll just send out scouts everywhere. There we go, that's fine, calling the guy. Yeah, we have the charges done as well. Oh, come on! Going to waste a nuke here. Gonna kill this commander ghost with 30 kills. What a shame. He should cancel. Did he cancel? No. Still there. Oh, it survives? I had no idea that the ghost can survive a nuke. Maybe it's because it was running away. Wow. Yeah, that's probably it. Oh, the game cuts off here. I guess this is when BattleNet went down, because that was also part of the post that I saw. Alright, so Arath would have won, but instead he got kicked off BattleNet.